Not a normal. I'm not getting any good shots on him.
Yeah.
It's all good. He's still going down. Frag the Weak is still doing pretty good.
Yeah, I just know in my head.
Even if I'm only getting 1,000 on him, I'm getting more because he's not paying attention to me.
Yeah.
Alright, we got incoming.
I got him.
Dude, I still got most of my grenade.
Yeah, you did. It's only got 2 orbs wide. Oh, hi, Mr. Goblin.
I saved my special for when I need to go out and clear out, like, the fourth wave or resurrect. That's my strategy on this one, folks. Why I usually don't die on it. I still don't think they should be able to shoot through their own shield, because technically, scientifically, it doesn't make sense. Unless they're using 2 phase variances, but... That's fine. This wave starts to get a little tougher on the drops. What I find too is a lot of people play with their Warlock or Hunter like a Titan, and Titans play like a Warlock and so on. Each character doesn't need to be restrained to a type of play, but there is definitely like the self-resurrection of the Warlock, the shield bump of the Titan, you know, the Hunter's invisibility, you know, these all give them the ability. None of them are better snipers. None of them are better, you know, big gunners. That's up to you and your weapon.
Yeah, I'm unloading. I just took down a chunk of his shield, of his health.
But the abilities, like the charge shield of the Titan when they run a big old shield in front of them. The Hunter's ability to go invisible and not be seen and hurt by enemies. He knows he's almost dead, he's getting pissed. Charging shield and ammo. Got no shot on him. I can't see him. Oh, he's like way behind us.
I just went up and took a chunk out of him with my super.
Should they announce Kudendig? God, I can't even see him. He's just like perfectly behind my wall. Come on, motherfucker, there you go. Come on, move out. Move out. Come to daddy.
Damn it.
I got him. A shuffle.
One tendril of the death surge has been set, but the present feels still in other places.
Tallid's journal. Encrypted exotic bounty. Part done. Alright. And he throws it. Why do people do this shit? I just don't get it. Just punch each other and hit each other. I mean, for one, it usually doesn't do much, and if it does, it's just slightly annoying, but it's like, I just don't get that mentality. Like, In all games, all around, across the board. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies. Whammies.
Darn, I would have liked it. I would have liked that engram. But mine.
Now, let's see what the Tolan's Fragment Journal Exotic Bounty Step 3 is. I think it is a Crucible-based one, though.
Launching the wire.
Tower. I gotta turn some stuff.
What?
Bring the journal to Ikorori Ray. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this one. It looks like it's done. I mean, I think I turn it in, and then he gives me the next stage. I was thinking of strategies last night to do the suicide thralls for the next urn bounty. Like, you pretty much just gotta stick them, get them, and then jump back and wait till you're fully recharged. So it's not gonna be able to do, like, 3 in a row. But remember on the moon where we were doing that little cluster down below, and there was just, like, a ton of them running through?
Yeah.
And you didn't have it yet, and me and Yuzi were doing it. I think that's going to be the best place, because there's like
I still don't have it.
5 suiciders there. Yeah, it's kind of a shitty thing. I think you should be able to buy it with Motes of Light or Strange Coins. I think you should be able to buy Strange Coins with Motes of Light, because they're doing things with Xur that are both Motes of Light and Strange Coins, so obviously he considers them worthy currencies. And it's not to make it easier, it's just... There's not a lot to spend with the Motes of Light. There's not much in the speaker that I want. I've got all the capes I want already, like 75 Motes of Light's worth. The exotic engram being a helmet almost every time for 25 Motes of Light from Xur. I don't want an exotic helmet. I already got one. I want exotic guns. I want it to be like an exotic engram that could be anything exotic. I don't want it to be limited to just helmets. That's the only reason I didn't buy one this week. Alright. Let's see if I've dropped any loot first. Oh, I gotta go see my... That's who that guy is. I can't remember who he was. He's my vanguard. I did. I dropped one item.
Nope, I didn't drop anything.
Now I'm gonna go see my dude. And as like I said, there's Xur. Still there. Same spot. Now, he will be gone by tomorrow. That's for sure. I gotta go see the warlock one. That's why it makes sense.
There we go.
Come on.
Good.
Just gives me another bounty to do. Thanks a lot. Let's see what this one is. Oh, wait. No, I just got to bring it to the gunsmith. Could this be it? That is far too easy. Oh, not right this second, but you can just set it. There's no way that could have been all there was to do on this one. Hey.
Let's get started.
No. Obtain a darkness-infused weapon frame from Xur. Okay, so I'm probably going to have to go spend... Well, that's cool because Xur's here today, so I can go do that right now. Now, this might cost me my strange coins that I have because I only have like 5 left. But you know what? For this gun, I've been looking... This is an exotic auto rifle. It's like barrel is covered by the skull of an eagle. I kind of want it. A weapon component instilled with power of your enemies. One strange coin. Dude! How come I'm missing a strange coin? Yesterday I had 5, now I have 4. Oh, wait, no. I think yesterday I had 5 and I spent one. That's right.
Yeah,
I
spent one on the urn.
Yeah, I thought I had 6 and spent it. Alright, so I got a weapon. That was pretty random. I've never heard them say that before. bring the weapon frame to the... Oh, my God. To the gunsmith. Okay. Yes. That Crucible guy was all like, oh, the Traveler picked a winner this time.
Oh, what? Do you have to have the bounty in order to get the urn from him?
Yeah, you have to go get the purple bounty from her. And then you go buy the urn. And then you go back to her.
Coin.
Yeah.
Not a moment too soon.
All right, the fuck's this say now? Darkness infused pulse rifle. Exotic weapon bounty. Defeat guardians in the crucible. 10,000. I have to kill 10,000 guardians. I have to get 10,000 kills in the crucible.
That'd take forever.
No, but that's why I wanted to finish the strike before we jumped back into the heavy crucible, because I knew that I was going to have... I had looked up on a friend of mine's YouTube, and that's how I learned about the exotic bounties. I didn't really... I thought it said it was only like...
Yes, God.
I don't know what it said. I don't really care, but... Confirmed.
Exchange complete.
Okay, now go over here. Thank you, man. People watch me when they watch me. Saturday's just a busy morning, you know? A lot of people are doing stuff. Like I said, the holidays are coming up. Last week before, you know. I had like 7 engrams. And it's all crap except for that mode of light.
I'm floating. Oh, it's a blue flood.
There's also, you know, like, heavy nights on Twitch are like Friday nights and Saturday nights, which I don't usually do right now. Usually on Friday nights we used to do DayZ in the evening, which was always a big one. You know, just one of those things, though, with when you're a streamer, you know, whether you got no one watching you or 1,000 people watching you, you just kind of got to do your thing. Enjoy the game you're playing, have a good time doing it, because otherwise your show is just yelling at people and bitching at people, and, you know, what I'm trying to focus away from doing a lot of lately, you know, having to deal with, you know, shitty attitudes and squabbling and bad microphones and things like that. My first month of streaming, I don't think I had anyone watching me really ever. I think my first 3 weeks I didn't even have a follower, but you just kind of got to keep doing it. But I also make YouTube videos out of these, so... It'd be really silly if no one was watching me and I wasn't playing with anyone. I just sat here quietly. You know? Jester, Aurora, whatever that weird number is. Undercity. I've never seen that one. Thunder Devil.
Yeah, that's the one I want.
Oh, that is nice.
But I only have 848.
I'm going to buy a couple of these. Ew. Undercity is pretty ugly.
Tell your friends about old Thunder Devil's the one I want.
I know, I just bought it. Boom, shakalaka.
Nice.
Yeah, I like it. I'm gonna go see, I kind of feel like going and buying that exotic engram from Xur just to see what it is helmet-wise. Because I have so many motes of light and I have nothing to spend it on. But here's the thing. I'm going to spend it, get a helmet that I probably don't want or need. Probably one of the same one I have. But you know what's cool is you can break it down for an exotic shard. So that's a way you can buy an exotic shard for 25 motes of light. I just thought of that. So I'm going to do that right now.
I am an agent.
All right, so I just bought my exotic engram. I'm going to go decrypt it. Now watch, it comes up like a rare helmet.
That'd be funny.
Dude, I would be riding Destiny Bungie right now. I'd be like, you motherfuckers owe me fucking 25 motes of light, or I'm going to mail you sperm. These engrams were
buried under
Oh, crap. It gave me a warlock helmet.
Oh.
I was hoping it would give me a titan helmet. It's okay. I'm going to break it down right now. Bye-bye, dismantle. Bam, exotic shard, right there. So I'm going to go...
In 47 minutes, the Vanguard resets. Well, the Vanguard...
Now I'm going to go pay Xur to upgrade my Icebreaker.
Nice.
Not me.
Upgrade Icebreaker... Gonna cost most of my glimmer, but there we go. Now my icebreaker is skill tree was half.